الحديث الأول عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: لما قضى الله الخلق كتب في كتابه على نفسه فهو موضوع عنده: إن رحمتي تغلب غضبي. رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري والنسائي وابن ماجه.
Hadith 1. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, When Allah decreed the creation, he pledged himself by writing in his book which is laid down with him, My mercy prevails over my wrath. It was related by Muslim, also by Bukhari, An-Nasa'i and Ibn Majah.
الحديث الثاني عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: قال الله تعالى: كذبني ابن آدم ولم يكن له ذلك، وشتمني ولم يكن له ذلك، فأما تكذيبه إياي فقوله: لن يعيدني كما بدأني، وليس أول الخلق بأهون علي من إعادته، وأما شتمه إياي فقوله: اتخذ الله ولدا، وأنا الأحد الصمد، لم ألد ولم أولد، ولم يكن لي كفوا أحد. رواه البخاري وكذلك النسائي.
حديث 2. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, Allah the Almighty has said, The son of Adam denied me, and he had no right to do so. And he reviled me, and he had no right to do so. As for his denying me, it is his saying, He will not remake me as he made me at first. And the initial creation of him is no easier for me than remaking him. As for his reviling me, it is his saying, Allah has taken to himself a son, while I am the one, the everlasting refuge. I begot not, nor was I begotten, and there is none comparable to me. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by An-Nasa'i.
الحديث الثالث عن زيد بن خالد الجهني رضي الله عنه قال: صلى لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلاة الصبح بالحديبية على إثر سماء كانت من الليلة، فلما انصرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أقبل على الناس فقال لهم: هل تدرون ماذا قال ربكم؟ قالوا: الله ورسوله أعلم. قال: أصبح من عبادي مؤمن بي وكافر، فأما من قال مطرنا بفضل الله ورحمته فذلك مؤمن بي كافر بالكوكب، وأما من قال مطرنا بنوء كذا وكذا فذلك كافر بي مؤمن بالكوكب. رواه البخاري وكذلك مالك والنسائي.
حديث 3. On the authority of Zayd ibn Khalid al-Juhani, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, The Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, led the morning prayer for us at al-Hudaybiyah following rainfall during the night. When the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, finished, he faced the people and said to them, Do you know what your Lord has said? They said, Allah and His Messenger know best. He said, This morning, one of my servants became a believer in me, and one a disbeliever. As for him who said, We have been given rain by virtue of Allah and His mercy, that one is a believer in me, a disbeliever in the stars. And as for him who said, We have been given rain by such and such a star, that one is a disbeliever in me, a believer in the stars. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Malik and An-Nasa'i.
الحديث الرابع عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: قال الله يسب بنو آدم الظهر وأنا الظهر بيد الليل والنهار رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم.
Hadith 4. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah said, Sons of Adam, inveigh against the vicissitudes of time, and I am time, in my hand is the night and the day. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim.
الحديث الخامس عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله تبارك وتعالى أنا أغنى الشركاء عن الشرك من عمل عملا أشرك فيه غيري تركته وشركه رواه مسلم وكذلك ابن ماجة.
حديث 5. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah, glorified and exalted be He, said, I am so self-sufficient that I am in no need of having an associate. Thus he who does an action for someone else's sake as well as mine will have that action renounced by me to him whom he associated with me. It was related by Muslim, also by Ibn Majah.
الحديث السادس عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن أول الناس يقضى يوم القيامة عليه رجل استشهد فأوتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال قاتلت فيك حتى استشهدت قال كذبت ولكنك قاتلت لأن يقال جريء فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار ورجل تعلم العلم وعلمه وقرأ القرآن فأتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال تعلمت العلم وعلمته وقرأت فيك القرآن قال كذبت ولكنك تعلمت العلم ليقال عالم وقرأت القرآن ليقال هو قارئ فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار ورجل وسع الله عليه وأعطاه من أصناف المال كله فأتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال ما تركت من سبيل تحب أن ينفق فيها إلا أنفقت فيها لك قال كذبت ولكنك فعلت ليقال هو جواد فقد قيل ثم أمر به فسحب على وجهه ثم ألقي في النار رواه مسلم وكذلك الترمذي والنسائي.
Hadith 6. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, say, The first of people against whom judgment will be pronounced on the day of resurrection will be a man who has died a martyr. He will be brought and Allah will make known to him his favors and he will recognize them. The Almighty will say, And what did you do about them? He will say, I fought for you until I died a martyr. He will say, You have lied. You did but fight that it may be said of you. He is courageous. And so it was said. Then he will be ordered to be dragged along on his face until he is cast into hellfire. Another will be a man who has studied religious knowledge and has taught it and who used to recite the Quran. He will be brought and Allah will make known to him his favors and he will recognize them. The Almighty will say, And what did you do about them? He will say, I studied religious knowledge and I taught it and I recited the Quran for your sake. He will say, You have lied. You did but study religious knowledge that it might be said of you. He is learned. And you recited the Quran that it might be said of you. He is a reciter. And so it was said. Then he will be ordered to be dragged along on his face until he is cast into hellfire. Another will be a man whom Allah had made rich and to whom he had given all kinds of wealth. He will be brought and Allah will make known to him his favors and he will recognize them. The Almighty will say, And what did you do about them? He will say, I left no path untrodden in which you like money to be spent without spending in it for your sake. He will say, You have lied. You did but do so that it might be said of you, He is open-handed. And so it was said. Then he will be ordered to be dragged along on his face until he is cast into hellfire. It was related by Muslim, also by At-Tirmidhi and An-Nasa'i.
الحديث السابع عن عقبة بن عامر رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول يعجب ربك من راعي غنم في رأس شظية الجبل يؤذن بالصلاة ويصلي فيقول الله عز وجل انظروا إلى عبدي هذا يؤذن ويقيم الصلاة يخاف مني قد غفرت لعبدي وأدخلته الجنة رواه النسائي بسند صحيح.
Hadith 7. On the authority of Uqba bin Amir, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, say, Your Lord delights at a shepherd who, on the peak of a mountain crag, gives the call to prayer and prays. Then Allah, glorified and exalted be He, says, Look at this servant of mine. He gives the call to prayer and performs the prayers. He is in awe of me. I have forgiven my servant his sins and have admitted him to paradise. It was related by An-Nasa'i with a good chain of authorities.
الحديث الثامن عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من صلى صلاة لم يقرأ فيها بأم القرآن فهي خداج ثلاثا غير تمام فقيل لأبي هريرة إنا نكون وراء الإمام فقال اقرأ بها في نفسك فإني سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول قال الله عز وجل قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي نصفين ولعبدي ما سأل فإذا قال العبد الحمد لله رب العالمين قال الله عز وجل حمدني عبدي وإذا قال الرحمن الرحيم قال الله عز وجل أثنى علي عبدي وإذا قال مالك يوم الدين قال الله مجدني عبدي وقال مرة فوض إلي عبدي فإذا قال إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين قال هذا بيني وبين عبدي ولعبدي ما سأل فإذا قال اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قال هذا لعبدي ولعبدي ما سأل رواه مسلم وكذلك مالك والترمذي وأبو داود والنسائي وابن ماجة
Hadith 8 On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him. From the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, A prayer performed by someone who has not recited the essence of the Quran during it is deficient, and he repeated the word 3 times, incomplete. Someone said to Abu Huraira, Even though we are behind the Imam, he said, Recite it to yourself. For I have heard the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, say, Allah, mighty and sublime be He, has said, I have divided prayer between myself and my servant into 2 halves, and my servant shall have what he has asked for. When the servant says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah, mighty and sublime be He, says, My servant has praised me. And when he says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah, mighty and sublime be He, says, My servant has extolled me. And when he says, Maliki Yawm al-Din, Allah says, My servant has glorified me. And on one occasion he said, My servant has submitted to my power. And when he says, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in, he says, This is between me and my servant, and my servant shall have what he has asked for. And when he says, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين, he says, this is for my servant, and my servant shall have what he has asked for. It was related by Muslim, also by Malik, At-Tirmidhi, Abu Dawood, An-Nasai, and Ibn Majah.
الحديث التاسع عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة من عمله صلاته, فإن صلحت فقد أفلح وأنجح, وإن فسدت فقد خاب وخسر, فإن انتقص من فريضته شيء قال الرب عز وجل انظروا هل لعبدي من تطوع فيكمل بها ما انتقص من الفريضة, ثم يكون سائر عمله على ذلك. رواه الترمذي وكذلك أبو داود والنسائي وابن ماجة وأحمد.
Hadith 9. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, the first of his actions for which a servant of Allah will be held accountable on the day of resurrection will be his prayers. If they are in order, then he will have prospered and succeeded. And if they are wanting, then he will have failed and lost. If there is something defective in his obligatory prayers, the Lord, glorified and exalted be he, will say, see if my servant has any supererogatory prayers with which may be completed that which was defective in his obligatory prayers. Then the rest of his actions will be judged in like fashion. It was related by At-Tirmidhi, also by Abu Dawood, An-Nasai, Ibn Majah, and Ahmad.
الحديث العاشر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يقول الله عز وجل الصوم لي وأنا أجزي به, يدع شهوته وأكله وشربه من أجلي, والصوم جنة, وللصائم فرحتان, فرحة حين يفطر وفرحة حين يلقى ربه, ولخلوف فم الصائم أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك. رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم ومالك والترمذي والنسائي وابن ماجه.
Hadith 10. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, Allah, mighty and sublime be he, says, fasting is mine, and it is I who give reward for it. A man gives up his sexual passion, his food and his drink for my sake. Fasting is like a shield, and he who fasts has two joys, a joy when he breaks his fast, and a joy when he meets his Lord. The change in the breath of the mouth of him who fasts is better in Allah's estimation than the smell of musk. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim, Malik, At-Tirmidhi, An-Nasai, and Ibn Majah.
الحديث الحادي عشر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله أنفق يا ابن آدم أنفق عليك. رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم.
Hadith 11. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah said, spend, O son of Adam, and I shall spend on you. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim.
الحديث الثاني عشر عن أبي مسعود الأنصاري رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حوسب رجل ممن كان قبلكم فلم يوجد له من الخير شيء إلا أنه كان يخالط الناس وكان موسرا, فكان يأمر غلمانه أن يتجاوزوا عن المعسر. قال قال الله نحن أحق بذلك منك, تجاوزوا عنه. رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري والنسائي.
حديث 12. On the authority of Abu Mas'ud al-Ansari, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, A man from among those who were before you was called to account. Nothing in the way of good was found for him, except that he used to have dealings with people. And being well-to-do, he would order his servants to let off the man in straitened circumstances from repaying his debt. He said that Allah said, We are worthier than you of that. Let him off. It was related by Muslim, also by Al-Bukhari and An-Nasa'i.
الحديث الثالث عشر عن عدي بن حاتم رضي الله عنه يقول كنت عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فجاءه رجلان أحدهما يشكو العيلة والآخر يشكو قطع السبيل فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما قطع السبيل فإنه لا يأتي عليك إلا قليل حتى تخرج العير إلى مكة بغير خفير وأما العيلة فإن الساعة لا تقوم حتى يطوف أحدكم بصدقته لا يجد من يقبلها منه ثم ليقفن أحدكم بين يدي الله ليس بينه وبينه حجاب ولا ترجمان يترجم له ثم ليقولن له ألم أؤتك مالا فيقولن بلى ثم ليقولن ألم أرسل إليك رسولا فليقولن بلى فينظر عن يمينه فلا يرى إلا النار ثم ينظر عن شماله فلا يرى إلا النار فليتقين أحدكم النار ولو بشق تمرة فإن لم يجد فبكلمة طيبة رواه البخاري.
حديث 13. On the authority of Adi ibn Hatim, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I was with the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him. And there came to him two men. One of them was complaining of penury, while the other was complaining of brigandry. The Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, As for brigandry, it will be but a short time before a caravan will be able to go out to Makkah without a guard. As for penury, The hour will not arrive before one of you takes his charity around without finding anyone to accept it from him. Then one of you will surely stand before Allah, there being no screen between him and him, nor an interpreter to translate for him. Then he will say to him, Did I not bring you wealth? And he will say, Yes. Then he will say, Did I not send to you a messenger? And he will say, Yes. And he will look to his right and will see nothing but hellfire. Then he will look to his left and will see nothing but hellfire. So let each of you protect himself against hellfire, be it with even half a date, and if he finds it not, then with a kind word. It was related by Al-Bukhari.
الحديث الرابع عشر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن لله تبارك وتعالى ملائكة سيارة فضلة يبتغون مجالس الذكر فإذا وجدوا مجلسا فيه ذكر قعدوا معهم وحف بعضهم بعضا بأجنحتهم حتى يملأوا ما بينهم وبين السماء الدنيا فإذا انصرفوا عرجوا وصعدوا إلى السماء قال فيسألهم الله عز وجل وهو أعلم بهم من أين جئتم فيقولون جئنا من عند عباد لك في الأرض يسبحونك ويكبرونك ويهللونك ويحمدونك ويسألونك قال وما يسألوني قالوا يسألونك جنتك قال وهل رأوا جنتي قالوا لا أي ربي قال فكيف لو رأوا جنتي قالوا ويستجيرونك قال ومما يستجيرونني قالوا من نارك يا رب قال وهل رأوا ناري قالوا لا قال فكيف لو رأوا ناري قالوا ويستغفرونك. قال فيقول قد غفرت لهم وأعطيتهم ما سألوا وأجرتهم مما استجاروا. قال يقولون رب فيهم فلان عبد خطاء إنما مر فجلس معهم. قال فيقول وله غفرت هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري والترمذي والنسائي.
Hadith 14. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, Allah, glorified and exalted be He, has supernumerary angels who rove about seeking out gatherings in which Allah's name is being invoked. They sit with them and fold their wings round each other, filling that which is between them and between the lowest heaven. When the people in the gathering depart, the angels ascend and rise up to heaven. He said, Then Allah, mighty and sublime be He, asks them, though He is the most knowing about them, From where have you come? And they say, We have come from some servants of yours on earth. They were glorifying you, exalting you, witnessing that there is no God but you, praising you, and asking favors of you. He says, And what do they ask of me? They say, They ask of you your paradise. He says, And have they seen my paradise? They say, No, O Lord. He says, And how would it be were they to have seen my paradise? They say, And they ask protection of you. He says, From what do they ask protection of me? They say, From your hellfire, O Lord. He says, And have they seen my hellfire? They say, No. He says, And how would it be were they to have seen my hellfire? They say, And they ask for your forgiveness. He said, Then he says, I have forgiven them, and I have bestowed upon them what they have asked for, and I have granted them sanctuary from that which they ask protection. He said, They say, O Lord, among them is so-and-so, a much sinning servant who was merely passing by and sat down with them. He said, And he says, And to him too I have given forgiveness. He who sits with such people shall not suffer. It was related by Muslim, also by Al-Bukhari, At-Tirmidhi and An-Nasai.
الحديث الخامس عشر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الله تعالى أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وأنا معه إذا ذكرني فإن ذكرني في نفسه ذكرته في نفسي وإن ذكرني في ملأ ذكرته في ملأ خير منه وإن تقرب إلي بشبر تقربت إليه ذراعا وإن تقرب إلي ذراعا تقربت إليه باعا وإن أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولة. رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم والترمذي وابن ماجه.
Hadith 15. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah the Almighty says, I am as my servant thinks I am. I am with him when he makes mention of me. If he makes mention of me to himself, I make mention of him to myself. And if he makes mention of me in an assembly, I make mention of him in an assembly better than it. And if he draws near to me a hand span, I draw near to him an arm's length. And if he draws near to me an arm's length, I draw near to him a fathom's length. And if he comes to me walking, I go to him at speed. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim, At-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah.
الحديث السادس عشر عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يروي عن ربه عز وجل قال إن الله كتب الحسنات والسيئات ثم بين ذلك فمن هم بحسنة فلم يعملها كتبها الله له عنده حسنة كاملة فإن هو هم بها فعملها كتبها الله له عنده عشر حسنات إلى 700 ضعف إلى أضعاف كثيرة ومن هم بسيئة فلم يعملها كتبها الله له عنده حسنة كاملة، فإن هو هم بها فعملها كتبها الله سيئة واحدة. رواه البخاري ومسلم.
حديث 16. On the authority of the son of Abbas, may Allah be pleased with them both. From the messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him. That among the sayings he related from his Lord, glorified and exalted be he, is that he said, Allah has written down the good deeds and the bad ones. Then he explained it by saying that he who has intended a good deed and has not done it, Allah writes it down with himself as a full good deed. But if he has intended it and has done it, Allah writes it down with himself as from 10 good deeds to 700 times or many times over. But if he has intended a bad deed and has not done it, Allah writes it down with himself as a full good deed. But if he has intended it and has done it, Allah writes it down as one bad deed. It was related by Al-Bukhari and Muslim.
الحديث السابع عشر عن أبي ذر الغفاري رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه عز وجل أنه قال يا عبادي إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا يا عبادي كلكم ضال إلا من هديته فاستهدوني أهدكم يا عبادي كلكم جائع إلا من أطعمته فاستطعموني أطعمكم يا عبادي كلكم عار إلا من كسوته فاستكسوني أكسكم يا عبادي إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا فاستغفروني أغفر لكم يا عبادي إنكم لن تبلغوا ضري فتضروني ولن تبلغوا نفعي فتنفعوني يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل واحد منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أفجر قلب رجل واحد منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا في صعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل واحد مسألته ما نقص ذلك مما عندي إلا كما ينقص المخيط إذا أدخل البحر يا عبادي إنما هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم ثم أوفيكم إياها فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلومن إلا نفسه رواه مسلم وكذلك الترمذي وابن ماجه.
حديث 17. On the authority of Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, may Allah be pleased with him. From the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him. Is that among the sayings he relates from his Lord, may he be glorified, is that he said, O my servants, I have forbidden oppression for myself and have made it forbidden amongst you, so do not oppress one another. O my servants, all of you are astray except for those I have guided, so seek guidance of me and I shall guide you. O my servants, all of you are hungry except for those I have fed, so seek food of me and I shall feed you. O my servants, all of you are naked except for those I have clothed. So seek clothing of me, and I shall clothe you. O my servants, you sin by night and by day, and I forgive all sins. So seek forgiveness of me, and I shall forgive you. O my servants, you will not attain harming me so as to harm me, and you will not attain benefiting me so as to benefit me. O my servants, were the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you to be as pious as the most pious heart of any one man of you, that would not increase my kingdom in anything. O my servants, were the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you to be as wicked as the most wicked heart of any one man of you, that would not decrease my kingdom in anything. O my servants, were the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you to rise up in one place and make a request of me, And were I to give everyone what he had requested, that would not decrease what I have, any more than a needle decreases the sieve if put into it. O my servants, it is but your deeds that I reckon up for you, and then recompense you for. So let him who finds good praise Allah, and let him who finds other than that blame no one but himself. It was related by Muslim, also by At-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah.
الحديث الثامن عشر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله عز وجل يقول يوم القيامة يا ابن آدم مرضت فلم تعدني قال يا ربي وكيف أعودك وأنت رب العالمين قال أما علمت أن عبدي فلانا مرض فلم تعده أما علمت أنك لو عدته لوجدتني عنده يا ابن آدم استطعمتك فلم تطعمني قال يا رب وكيف أطعمك وأنت رب العالمين قال أما علمت أنه استطعمك عبدي فلان فلم تطعمه أما علمت أنك لو أطعمته لوجدت ذلك عندي يا ابن آدم استسقيتك فلم تسقني قال يا ربي كيف أسقيك وأنت رب العالمين قال استسقاك عبدي فلان فلم تسقه أما إنك لو سقيته لوجدت ذلك عندي رواه مسلم.
حديث 18. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah, mighty and sublime be He, will say on the day of resurrection, O son of Adam, I fell ill and you visited me not. He will say, O Lord, and how should I visit you when you are the Lord of the worlds? He will say, Did you not know that my servant so-and-so had fallen ill and you visited him not? Did you not know that had you visited him, you would have found me with him, O son of Adam? I asked you for food and you fed me not. He will say, O Lord, and how should I feed you when you are the Lord of the worlds? He will say, Did you not know that my servant so-and-so asked you for food and you fed him not? Did you not know that had you fed him, you would surely have found that with me? O son of Adam, I asked you to give me to drink and you gave me not to drink. He will say, O Lord, how should I give you to drink when you are the Lord of the worlds? He will say, My servant so-and-so asked you to give him to drink, and you gave him not to drink. Had you given him to drink, you would have surely found that with me. It was related by Muslim.
الحديث التاسع عشر عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله عز وجل الكبرياء ردائي والعظمة إزاري فمن نازعني واحدا منهما قذفته في النار رواه أبو داود وكذلك ابن ماجة وأحمد بأسانيد صحيحة.
Hadith 19. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said that Allah, glorified and exalted be He, said, Pride is my cloak and greatness my robe, and he who competes with me in respect of either of them, I shall cast into hellfire. It was related by Abu Dawood, also by Ibn Majah and Ahmad, with sound chains of authority.
الحديث العشرون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال تفتح أبواب الجنة يوم الاثنين ويوم الخميس فيغفر لكل عبد لا يشرك بالله شيئا إلا رجلا كانت بينه وبين أخيه شحناء فيقال أنظروا هذين حتى يصطلحا أنظروا هذين حتى يصطلحا أنظروا هذين حتى يصطلحا رواه مسلم وكذلك مالك وأبو داود.
Hadith 20. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, "The gates of paradise will be opened on Mondays and on Thursdays, and every servant of Allah who associates nothing with Allah will be forgiven, except for the man who has a grudge against his brother. About them it will be said, 'Delay these two until they are reconciled. Delay these two until they are reconciled. Delay these two until they are reconciled.'" It was related by Muslim, also by Malik and Abu Dawood.
الحديث الحادي والعشرون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: قال الله تعالى: ثلاثة أنا خصمهم يوم القيامة، رجل أعطى بي ثم غدر، ورجل باع حرا فأكل ثمنه، ورجل استأجر أجيرا فاستوفى منه ولم يعطه أجره. رواه البخاري وكذلك ابن ماجه وأحمد.
Hadith 21. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said that Allah the Almighty said, "There are three whose adversary I shall be on the day of resurrection: a man who has given his word by me and has broken it, a man who has sold a free man and has consumed the price, and a man who has hired a workman, has exacted his due in full from him and has not given him his wage." It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Ibn Majah and Ahmad ibn Hanbal.
الحديث الثاني والعشرون عن أبي سعيد رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يحقر أحدكم نفسه. قالوا: يا رسول الله، كيف يحقر أحدنا نفسه؟ قال: يرى أمر الله عليه فيه مقال ثم لا يقول فيه، فيقول الله عز وجل له يوم القيامة: ما منعك أن تقول في كذا وكذا؟ فيقول: خشية الناس. فيقول: فإياي كنت أحق أن تخشى. رواه ابن ماجة بسند صحيح.
حديث 22. On the authority of Abu Sa'id, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, "Let not any one of you belittle himself." They said, "O Messenger of Allah, how can any one of us belittle himself?" He said, "He finds a matter concerning Allah about which he should say something, and he does not say it. So Allah, mighty and sublime be He, says to him on the day of resurrection, 'What prevented you from saying something about such and such and such and such?' He says, 'It was out of fear of people.' Then he says, 'Rather, it is I whom you should more properly fear.'" It was related by Ibn Majah with a sound chain of authorities.
الحديث الثالث والعشرون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله يقول يوم القيامة: أين المتحابون بجلالي؟ اليوم أظلهم في ظلي، يوم لا ظل إلا ظلي. رواه البخاري وكذلك مالك.
Hadith 23. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, "Allah will say on the day of resurrection, 'Where are those who love one another through my glory? Today I shall give them shade in my shade, it being a day when there is no shade but my shade.'" It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Malik.
الحديث الرابع والعشرون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله إذا أحب عبدا دعا جبريل عليه السلام فقال: إني أحب فلانا فأحبه. قال: فيحبه جبريل، ثم ينادي في السماء فيقول: إن الله يحب فلانا فأحبوه، فيحبه أهل السماء. قال: ثم يوضع له القبول في الأرض، وإذا أبغض الله عبدا دعا جبريل فيقول إني أبغض فلانا فأبغضه فيبغضه جبريل، ثم ينادي في أهل السماء إن الله يبغض فلانا فأبغضوه، قال فيبغضونه، ثم توضع له البغضاء في الأرض. رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري ومالك والترمذي.
Hadith 24. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, if Allah has loved a servant of his, he calls Jibreel, on whom be peace, and says, I love so and so, therefore love him. He said, so Jibreel loves him. Then he calls out in heaven, saying, Allah loves so and so, therefore love him. And the inhabitants of heaven love him. He said, then acceptance is established for him on earth. And if Allah has abhorred a servant of his, he calls Jibreel and says, I abhor so and so, therefore abhor him. So Jibreel abhors him. Then he calls out to the inhabitants of heaven, Allah abhors so and so, therefore abhor him. He said, so they abhor him, and abhorrence is established for him on earth. It was related by Muslim, also by Al-Bukhari, Malik and At-Tirmidhi.
الحديث الخامس والعشرون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله عز وجل قال من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضت عليه وما يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به ويده التي يبطش بها ورجله التي يمشي بها وإن سألني لأعطينه ولئن استعاذني لأعيذنه وما ترددت عن شيء أنا فاعله ترددي عن نفس عبد المؤمن يكره الموت وأنا أكره مساءته. رواه البخاري.
Hadith 25. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah, mighty and sublime be He, said, whosoever shows enmity to someone devoted to me, I shall be at war with him. My servant draws not near to me with anything more loved by me than the religious duties I have enjoined upon him. And my servant continues to draw near to me with supererogatory works so that I shall love him. When I love him, I am his hearing with which he hears, his seeing with which he sees, his hand with which he strikes, and his foot with which he walks. Were he to ask something of me, I would surely give it to him, and were he to ask me for refuge, I would surely grant him it. I do not hesitate about anything as much as I hesitate about seizing the soul of my faithful servant. He hates death, and I hate hurting him. It was related by Al-Bukhari.
الحديث السادس والعشرون عن أبي أمامة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله عز وجل إن أغبض أوليائي عندي لمؤمن خفيف الحاذ ذو حظ من الصلاة أحسن عبادة ربه وأطاعه في السر وكان غامضا في الناس لا يشار إليه بالأصابع وكان رزقه كفافا فصبر على ذلك ثم نفض بيده ثم قال عجلت منيته قلت بواكيه قل تراثه. رواه الترمذي وكذلك أحمد وابن ماجه وإسناده حسن.
Hadith 26. On the authority of Abu Umama, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said that Allah, mighty and sublime be He, said, truly, of those devoted to me, the one I most favor is a believer who is of meager means and much given to prayer, who has been particular in the worship of his Lord and has obeyed him inwardly, who was obscure among people and not pointed out, and whose sustenance was just sufficient to provide for him, yet he bore this patiently. Then he rapped with his hand and said, Death will have come early to him, his mourners will have been few, his estate scant. It was related by At-Tirmidhi, also by Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Ibn Majah. Its chain of authorities is sound.
الحديث السابع والعشرون عن مسروق قال سألنا أو سألت عبد الله أي ابن مسعود عن هذه الآية ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون قال أما إنا قد سألنا عن ذلك فقال أرواحهم في جوف طير خضر لها قناديل معلقة بالعرش تسرح من الجنة حيث شاءت ثم تأوي إلى تلك القناديل واطلع إليهم ربهم اطلاعة فقال هل تشتهون شيئا؟ قالوا أي شيء نشتهي ونحن نسرح من الجنة حيث شئنا ففعل ذلك بهم ثلاث مرات فلما رأوا أنهم لن يتركوا من أن يسألوا قالوا يا رب نريد أن ترد أرواحنا في أجسادنا حتى نقتل في سبيلك مرة أخرى فلما رأى أن ليس لهم حاجة تركوا رواه مسلم وكذلك الترمذي والنسائي وابن ماجه
Hadith 27, on the authority of Masruq, who said, We asked, or I asked, Abdullah, that is Ibn Mas'ud, about this verse. And do not regard those who have been killed in the cause of Allah as dead. Rather, they are alive with their Lord, being provided for. He said, We asked about that, and he said, Their souls are in the insides of green birds, having lanterns suspended from the throne, roaming freely in paradise where they please, then taking shelter in those lanterns. So their Lord cast a glance at them and said, Do you wish for anything? They said, What shall we wish for when we roam freely in paradise where we pleased? And thus did he do to them three times. When they saw that they would not be spared from being asked again, they said, O Lord, we would like for you to put back our souls into our bodies so that we might fight for your sake once again. And when he saw that they were not in need of anything, they were let be. It was related by a Muslim, also by At-Tirmidhi, An-Nasai, and Ibn Majah.
الحديث الثامن والعشرون عن جندب بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في من كان قبلكم رجل به جرح فجزع فأخذ سكينا فحز بها يده فما رقى الدم حتى مات قال الله تعالى بادرني عبدي بنفسه حرمت عليه الجنة رواه البخاري
Hadith 28 On the authority of Jundub ibn Abdullah, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, There was amongst those before you a man who had a wound. He was in such anguish that he took a knife and made with it a cut in his hand, and the blood did not cease to flow till he died. Allah the Almighty said, My servant has himself forestalled me. I have forbidden him paradise. It was related by Al-Bukhari.
الحديث التاسع والعشرون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يقول الله تعالى ما لعبد المؤمن عندي جزاء إذا قبضت صفيه من أهل الدنيا ثم احتسبه إلا الجنة رواه البخاري
Hadith 29 On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah the Almighty says, My faithful servants reward from me. If I have taken to me his best friend from amongst the inhabitants of the world, and he has then borne it patiently for my sake, shall be nothing less than paradise. It was related by Al-Bukhari.
الحديث الثلاثون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال قال الله عز وجل إذا أحب عبدي لقائي أحببت لقاءه وإذا كره لقائي كرهت لقاءه رواه البخاري ومالك وفي رواية لمسلم توضح معنى الحديث عن عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب لقاء الله أحب الله لقاءه ومن كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه فقلت يا نبي الله أكراهية الموت فكلنا نكره الموت قال ليس كذلك ولكن المؤمن إذا بشر برحمة الله ورضوانه وجنته أحب لقاء الله فأحب الله لقاءه وإن الكافر إذا بشر بعذاب الله وسخطه كره لقاء الله وكره الله لقاءه.
Hadith 30. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah, mighty and sublime be He, said, If my servant likes to meet me, I like to meet him, and if he dislikes to meet me, I dislike to meet him. It was related by Al-Bukhari and Malik. A prophetic version by Muslim, which clarifies the meaning of the above sacred hadith, reads, On the authority of Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, He who likes to meet Allah, Allah likes to meet him, and he who dislikes to meet Allah, Allah dislikes to meet him. I said, O Prophet of Allah, is it because of the dislike of death? For all of us dislike death. He said, It is not so, but rather it is that when the believer is given news of Allah's mercy, his approval and his paradise, He likes to meet Allah, and Allah likes to meet him. But when the unbeliever is given news of Allah's punishment and his displeasure, he dislikes to meet Allah, and Allah dislikes to meet him.
الحديث الحادي والثلاثون عن جندب رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حدث أن رجلا قال والله لا يغفر الله لفلان وإن الله تعالى قال من ذا الذي يتألى علي ألا أغفر لفلان فإني قد غفرت لفلان وأحبطت عملك أو كما قال رواه مسلم.
Hadith 31. On the authority of Jundub, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, related. A man said, By Allah, Allah will not forgive so and so. At this, Allah the Almighty said, Who is he who swears by me that I will not forgive so and so? Verily, I have forgiven so and so, and have nullified your own good deeds. It was related by Muslim.
الحديث الثاني والثلاثون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أسرف رجل على نفسه فلما حضره الموت أوصى بنيه فقال إذا أنا مت فاحرقوني ثم اسحقوني ثم أدروني في البحر فوالله لئن قدر علي ربي ليعذبني عذابا ما عذبه أحد ففعلوا ذلك به فقال للأرض أدي ما أخذت فإذا هو قائم فقال له ما حملك على ما صنعت قال خشيتك يا رب أو مخافتك فغفر له ذلك رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري والنساء وابن ماجة
Hadith 32 On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, A man sinned greatly against himself, and when death came to him, he charged his son, saying, When I have died, burn me, then crush me, and scatter my ashes into the sea. For by Allah, if my Lord takes possession of me, he will punish me in a manner in which he has punished no one else. So they did that to him. Then he said to the earth, Produce what you have taken. And there he was. And he said to him, What induced you to do what you did? He said, Being afraid of you, O my Lord. Or he said, Being frightened of you. And because of that, he forgave him. It was related by Muslim, also by Al-Bukhari, Al-Nasai, and Ibn Majah.
الحديث الثالث والثلاثون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يحكي عن ربه عز وجل قال أذنب عبد ذنبا فقال اللهم اغفر لي ذنبي فقال تبارك وتعالى أذنب عبدي ذنبا فعلم أن له ربا يغفر الذنب ويأخذ به ثم عاد فأذنب فقال أي ربي اغفر لي ذنبي فقال تبارك وتعالى عبدي أذنب ذنبا فعلم أن له ربا يغفر الذنب ويأخذ به ثم عاد فأذنب فقال أي ربي اغفر لي ذنبي فقال تبارك وتعالى أذنب عبدي ذنبا فعلم أن له ربا يغفر الذنب ويأخذ بالذنب أعمل ما شئت فقد غفرت لك رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري
حديث 33 On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, from among the things he reports from his Lord, mighty and sublime be he, is that he said, A servant of Allah's committed a sin and said, O Allah, forgive me my sin. And he, glorified and exalted be he, said, My servant has committed a sin and has known that he is a Lord who forgives sins and punishes for them. Then he sinned again and said, O Lord, forgive me my sin. And he, glorified and exalted be he, said, My servant has committed a sin and has known that he has a Lord who forgives sins and punishes for them. Then he sinned again and said, O Lord, Forgive me my sin. And he, glorified and exalted be he, said, My servant has committed a sin and has known that he has a Lord who forgives sins and punishes for sins. Do what you wish, for I have forgiven you. It was related by Muslim, also by Al-Bukhari.
الحديث الرابع والثلاثون عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول قال الله تعالى يا ابن آدم إنك ما دعوتني ورجوتني غفرت لك على ما كان منك ولا أبالي يا ابن آدم لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء ثم استغفرتني غفرت لك يا ابن آدم إنك لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا ثم لقيتني لا تشرك بي شيئا لأتيتك بقرابها مغفرة رواه الترمذي وكذلك أحمد وسنده حسن
حديث 34 On the authority of Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, I heard the messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, say, Allah the Almighty said, O son of Adam, so long as you call upon me and ask of me, I shall forgive you for what you have done, and I shall not mind. O son of Adam, were your sins to reach the clouds of the sky, and were you then to ask forgiveness of me, I would forgive you. O son of Adam, were you to come to me with sins nearly as great as the earth, and were you then to face me, ascribing no partner to me, I would bring you forgiveness nearly as great as it. It was related by At-Tirmidhi, also by Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Its chain of authorities is sound.
الحديث الخامس والثلاثون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: يتنزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة إلى سماء الدنيا حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر، فيقول: من يدعوني فأستجيب له، من يسألني فأعطيه، من يستغفرني فأغفر له. رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم ومالك والترمذي وأبو داود، وفي رواية لمسلم زيادة: فلا يزال كذلك حتى يضيء الفجر.
Hadith 35. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Our Lord, glorified and exalted be He, descends each night to the earth's sky when there remains the final third of the night, and He says, Who is saying a prayer to me that I may answer it? Who is asking something of me that I may give it to him? Who is asking forgiveness of me that I may forgive him? It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim, Malik, At-Tirmidhi and Abu Dawud. In a version by Muslim, the hadith ends with the words, and thus he continues till the light of dawn shines.
Al-Hadith al-Sadis wa-Thalathun An Anas radiyallahu anhu عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: يجتمع المؤمنون يوم القيامة فيقولون: لو استشفعنا إلى ربنا، فيأتون آدم فيقولون: أنت أبو الناس، خلقك الله بيده وأسجد لك ملائكته وعلمك أسماء كل شيء، فاشفع لنا عند ربك حتى يريحنا من مكاننا هذا، فيقول: لست هناكم، ويذكر ذنبه فيستحي: ائتوا نوحا فإنه أول رسول بعثه الله إلى أهل الأرض، فيأتونه فيقول: لست هناكم، ويذكر سؤاله ربه ما ليس له به علم فيستحي، فيقول: ائتوا خليل الرحمن، فيأتونه فيقول: لست هناكم، ائتوا موسى عبدا كلمه الله وأعطاه التوراة، فيأتونه فيقول: لست هناكم، ويذكر قتل النفس بغير نفس، فيستحيي من ربه فيقول: ائتوا عيسى عبد الله ورسوله وكلمة الله وروحه، فيأتونه فيقول: لست هناكم، ائتوا محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبدا غفر الله له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر، فيأتونني فأنطلق حتى أستأذن على ربي فيؤذن، فإذا رأيت ربي وقعت ساجدا، فيدعني ما شاء الله، ثم يقال: ارفع رأسك وسل تعطى وقل يسمع واشفع تشفع، فأرفع رأسي فأحمده بتحميد يعلمنيه، ثم أشفع فيحد لي حدا فأدخلهم الجنة، ثم أعود إليه فإذا رأيت ربي فأقع ساجدا مثله، ثم أشفع فيحد لي حدا فأدخلهم الجنة، ثم أعود الثالثة، ثم أعود الرابعة، فأقول: ما بقي في النار إلا من حبسه القرآن ووجب عليه الخلود. رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم والترمذي وابن ماجه، وفي رواية أخرى للبخاري زيادة هي: قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: يخرج من النار من قال: لا إله إلا الله، وكان في قلبه من الخير ما يزن شعيرة، ثم يخرج من النار من قال: لا إله إلا الله، وكان في قلبه من الخير ما يزن بره ثم يخرج من النار من قال لا إله إلا الله وكان في قلبه ما يزن من الخير ضره.
Hadith 36. On the authority of Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, the believers will gather together on the day of resurrection and will say, should we not ask someone to intercede for us with our Lord? So they will come to Adam and will say, you are the father of mankind. Allah created you with His hand, and He made His angels bow down to you, and He taught you the names of everything. So intercede for us with your Lord, so that He may give us relief from this place where we are. And He will say, I am not in a position to do that. And He will mention His wrongdoing, and will feel ashamed, and will say, go to Noah, for he is the first messenger that Allah sent to the inhabitants of the earth. So they will come to him, and he will say, I am not in a position to do that. And he will mention his having requested something of his Lord about which he had no proper knowledge. And he will feel ashamed and will say, go to the friend of the merciful. So they will come to him and he will say, I am not in a position to do that. Go to Moses, a servant to whom Allah talked and to whom he gave the Torah. So they will come to him and he will say, I am not in a position to do that. And he will mention the taking of a life other than for a life. And he will feel ashamed in the sight of his Lord and will say, go to Jesus, Allah's servant and messenger, Allah's word and spirit. So they will come to him and he will say, I am not in a position to do that. Go to Muhammad, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, a servant to whom Allah has forgiven all his wrongdoing, past and future. So they will come to me and I shall set forth to ask permission to come to my Lord, and permission will be given. And when I shall see my Lord, I shall prostrate myself. He will leave me thus for such time as it pleases him. Then it will be said to me, raise your head, ask and it will be granted, speak and it will be heard, intercede and your intercession will be accepted. So I shall raise my head and praise him with a form of praise that he will teach me. Then I shall intercede and he will set me a limit as to the number of people. So I shall admit them into paradise. Then I shall return to him. And when I shall see my Lord, I shall bow down as before. Then I shall intercede and he will set me a limit as to the number of people. So I shall admit them into paradise. Then I shall return for a third time, then a fourth, and I shall say, there remains in hellfire only those whom the Quran has confined and who must be there for eternity. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim, At-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. Another version by Al-Bukhari adds, the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, there shall come out of hellfire he who has said, there is no God but Allah, and who has in his heart goodness weighing a barley corn. Then there shall come out of hellfire he who has said, there is no God but Allah, and who has in his heart goodness weighing a grain of wheat. Then there shall come out of hellfire he who has said, there is no God but Allah, and who has in his heart goodness weighing an atom.
الحديث السابع والثلاثون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله أعددت لعباد الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر فاقرأوا إن شئتم فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين رواه البخاري ومسلم والترمذي وابن ماجة.
Hadith 37. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah said, I have prepared for my righteous servants what no eye has seen and no ear has heard, nor has it occurred to human heart. Thus recite if you wish, and no soul knows what joy for them has been kept hidden. It was related by Al-Bukhari, Muslim, At-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah.
الحديث الثامن والثلاثون عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: لما خلق الله الجنة والنار أرسل جبريل إلى الجنة فقال: انظر إليها وإلى ما أعددت لأهلها فيها. قال: فجاءها ونظر إليها وإلى ما أعد الله لأهلها فيها. قال: فرجع إليه قال: فعزتك لا يسمع بها أحد إلا دخلها. فأمر بها فحفت بالمكاره، فقال: ارجع إليها فانظر إلى ما أعددت لأهلها فيها. قال: فرجع إليها فإذا هي قد حفت بالمكاره، فرجع إليه فقال: وعزتك لقد خفت ألا يدخلها أحد. قال: اذهب إلى النار فانظر إليها وما أعددت لأهلها فيها، فإذا هي يركب بعضها بعضا. فرجع إليه فقال: وعزتك لا يسمع بها أحد فيدخلها. فأمر بها فحفت بالشهوات، فقال: ارجع إليها. فرجع إليها فقال: وعزتك لقد خشيت ألا ينجو منها أحد إلا دخلها. رواه الترمذي وقال: حديث حسن صحيح، وكذلك أبو داود والنسائي.
Hadith 38. On the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, from the Messenger of Allah, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, when Allah created paradise and hellfire, he sent Jibreel to paradise, saying, look at it and at what I have prepared therein for its inhabitants. He said, so he came to it and looked at it and at what Allah had prepared therein for its inhabitants. He said, so he returned to him and said, by your glory, no one hears of it without entering it. So he ordered that it be encompassed by forms of hardship. And he said, return to it and look at what I have prepared therein for its inhabitants. He said, so he returned to it and found that it was encompassed by forms of hardship. Then he returned to him and said, by your glory, I fear that no one will enter it. He said, go to hellfire and look at it and at what I have prepared therein for its inhabitants. And he found that it was in layers, one above the other. Then he returned to him and said, by your glory, no one who hears of it will enter it. So he ordered that it be encompassed by lusts. Then he said, return to it. And he returned to it and said, by your glory, I am frightened that no one will escape from entering it. It was related by At-Tirmidhi, who said that it was a good and sound hadith, also by Abu Dawud and An-Nasa'i.
الحديث التاسع والثلاثون عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: احتجت الجنة والنار، فقالت النار: في الجبارون والمتكبرون، وقالت الجنة: في ضعفاء الناس ومساكينهم، فقضى الله بينهما: إنك الجنة رحمتي، أرحم بك من أشاء، وإنك النار عذابي، أعذب بك من أشاء، ولكليكما علي ملؤها. رواه مسلم وكذلك البخاري والترمذي.
Hadith 39. On the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him. From the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, who said, paradise and hellfire disputed together. And hellfire said, in me are the mighty and the haughty. Paradise said, in me are the weak and the poor. So Allah judged between them, saying, you are paradise, my mercy. Through you I show mercy to those I wish. And you are hellfire, my punishment. Through you I punish those I wish. And it is incumbent upon me that each of you shall have its full. It was related by Muslim, also by Al-Bukhari and At-Tirmidhi.
الحديث الأربعون عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال: قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله يقول لأهل الجنة يا أهل الجنة فيقولون لبيك ربنا وسعديك والخير في يديك فيقول هل رضيتم؟ فيقولون وما لنا لا نرضى يا رب وقد أعطيتنا ما لم تعط أحدا من خلقك فيقول ألا أعطيكم أفضل من ذلك؟ فيقولون يا رب وأي شيء أفضل من ذلك؟ فيقول أحل عليكم رضواني فلا أسخط عليكم بعده أبدا. رواه البخاري وكذلك مسلم والترمذي.
Hadith 40. On the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Prophet, may the blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, said, Allah will say to the inhabitants of Paradise, O inhabitants of Paradise, they will say, O our Lord, we present ourselves and are at your pleasure, and goodness rests in your hands. Then he will say, Are you contented? And they will say, And how should we not be contented? O Lord, when you have given to us that which you have given to no one else of your creation, then he will say, Would you not like me to give you something better than that? And they will say, O Lord, and what thing is better than that? And he will say, I shall cause my favor to descend upon you, and thereafter shall never be displeased with you. It was related by Al-Bukhari, also by Muslim and At-Tirmidhi.